Mathematical functions can be challenging to comprehend. It might look like this, this, or that. Regardless though, almost all functions can be decomposed into simpler components. One way we can do that is by using Fourier series. More than that, you can also view a function in frequency domain by using Fourier transform. This is what I call frequency domain perspective, which complements time domain perspective. Let's dive into this further. The basic idea of Fourier series is to decompose any function f into many sinusoidal functions. To start with this, let us use a triangle wave. We start from the fundamental frequency, then increase the frequency little by little. As you add more and more frequencies, the Fourier approximation gets closer and closer to the triangle wave. What if we replace the triangle wave with a square wave? Let's start with the fundamental frequency. Now comes the second, the third, and so on. Wait, what's wrong with the discontinuities? The series approaches the square wave, but there is still some ringing at the jump discontinuities. This is called the Gibbs phenomenon. No matter how many harmonics are added, this ringing always shows up at the discontinuities. The most basic form of Fourier series is the trigonometric Fourier series. Each coefficient of this series can be computed by means of integration. The strength of the trigonometric form lies in the fact that both sine and cosine are real-valued functions. Its counterpart is the complex Fourier series. Compared to the trigonometric form, its calculation can be more involved because it employs complex numbers. Its strength, however, appears when you want to know its frequency spectrum. Simply put, a frequency spectrum indicates how strong its frequency contributes to the function. I am going to use the square wave as an example to demonstrate how to obtain the frequency spectrum. First, compute the coefficients of the complex Fourier series. Then take the absolute value of each coefficient and arrange them according to the harmonic multiplicity k. Now we can see that the lower frequencies contribute more than the higher frequencies. A more practical use involves a sinusoidal function. There are more than one frequency that compose this function. The actual calculation of its complex Fourier coefficients are a bit involved, so I'm just displaying the visual concept here. Each frequency has its own amplitude, which translates to this spectrum plot. In this case, there are only finite number of frequencies, unlike that of the square wave. Fourier series can be used when you want to know what happens to a signal when it is fed into a system with a frequency response. Let us feed that sinusoidal signal into a device with this frequency response. Here, I'm showing a low-pass filter. As a result of this filtering, the lower frequencies get stronger, while the higher ones get weaker. Now, somehow, our speaker's frequency response is flipped horizontally, and we end up with a high-pass filter. What happens is the reverse. The lower frequencies get suppressed, while the higher ones get amplified. If we combine both high-pass and low-pass filter, we can end up with two possibilities: the band-pass filter and the band-reject filter. The band-pass filter only allows a specific range of frequencies to pass or amplify. The band-reject filter works in the opposite way. It weakens a specific range of frequencies and amplifies or allows the rest. To study the Fourier transform, I want to revisit the square wave. Make it non-periodic. I'm left with just a square at the middle. Can I analyze this signal by using Fourier series? No. But there is another tool to use, the Fourier transform. I'd like to describe Fourier transform with one word: perspective. How do you see a signal? In its scale form, a signal is described as a function of time. What the Fourier transform does is this. It transforms the description of a signal from time domain into frequency domain. I'd argue that Fourier transform is more general than Fourier series, because it can be applied to both periodic and non-periodic signals. On the other hand, Fourier series can only be applied to periodic signals. The Fourier transform formula is obviously different. There are sine transform, cosine transform, and complex transform. My tool of choice is the complex transform because it comes in handy, very handy, upon displaying the frequency spectrum and the phase diagram. A time domain signal can be transformed into frequency domain by this integral. This is a very important integral, so I'd recommend you to actually memorize it. If you happen to be unlucky enough so that you only have the frequency domain representation, you can reverse the representation into time domain by using the inverse Fourier transform. Use the square wave as an example. Its Fourier transform is the sinc function. As you can see, this has a big loop at the middle, then the higher the frequency goes, the smaller the loops become. I love to interpret the result this way. The largest frequency component lies at omega equals 0. The square wave is obviously flat. It's like you turn on a switch and then you turn it off after some time. This flat non-zero part obviously has zero frequency, and it translates to a peak at omega equals 0. Where do the higher frequencies come from? Obviously the math calculation, right? I mean, why not? But let's see what happens if this flat non-zero part gets extended to plus and minus infinity. If the signal becomes longer, the lower frequencies dominate. Eventually, when this flat non-zero extends from minus infinity to plus infinity in the time domain, the frequency domain only gives you a Dirac delta. This means that the frequency is solely concentrated on omega equals 0. On the contrary, if you concentrate all energy of this time domain signal into a Dirac delta pulse, the frequency domain will give you a constant. Kindly please subscribe to us so that you will be always stay tuned to our frequency. Feel free to add more harmonics by commenting below. If you feel that this video can help your friend understand Fourier series and transform, share it to them. Thank you and see you next time.